Hello everybody, welcome back to Cities Skylines. Now, it's been a minute since I played. So I'll be honest here, I'm not 100% sure where we left off exactly, but we are going to do our best here. Once this starts loading, I haven't gotten any new assets or new mods this time around. It's mostly just gonna be a continuation. I think my goal for this stream is gonna be to get the downtown area expanded a little bit. I want to build it across that shoreline so that it finally connects all the way through. Build out our leisure areas, and that's most of what I want. I really hope the weather isn't going to completely mess this up for me. So we have the major downtown area, which I've called Hickory Square for some reason, mostly because I never thought to give it a better name. Where is everybody? There's weirdly not a lot of traffic in the city center. I've also never had the game stutter quite like that before. Anyway. That's all. How are we on noise? It's not too bad in this area. It's pretty bad in that corner. But it's not terrible here. So I might fill that out with some leisure. Do a cutoff like right there. And fill this in with some residential. We're going to move this up because that's just not cute. And I will say I'm starting to think about winding down this particular series only because I feel like I'm starting to come towards a good logical place to stop. And I definitely don't want to push it. I am neither Salt nor Peppa. And I do not want to push it real good. This is just me being a little picky. So sorry. And then we're going to smooth all that out because that's just a mess. Oh, so that's what's causing all of these issues. That's better. Am I going to have the same problem here? No, I don't think so. Okay. Then I think we still do. Yeah, power connects over there, so we're good on these. And in fact, just to be 100% safe, I don't know, we'll make that kind of like a service lane for the hotel. I don't know. I probably need to fix this whole junction at some point, but right now I can't be bothered. This is all going to be Blazure. And then this don't think we want that on the waterfront directly, so we're going to put some of that on there. Some of that. Some of that. And then this. Is just all gonna be that, except here, and that we're just gonna leave open. Maybe we'll put just some cute little offices here, just to add a little bit of a buffer, maybe. We'll see. Do I have water here? I do. And let's also check on noise levels here. They are not too bad, except up there. So, I'm pretty sure electric is going all the way through here as well. Yes, lovely. So then we're going to do another one of those little alleys. That all along this interior. All along this street and that street. And just along here. But on this side, we're going to do some offices. Because that's still pretty close to And then we're gonna put some offices up here just for fun. Okay, why is there a giant forest fire happening here? Uh-oh. Are there generally giant forest fires like this on beaches? Because I feel like that's not very likely. And why would these fire trucks actually leave the scene and then come back? Where's that Kierkegaard's? Kierkegaard. No. Weird. Okay. So that's gonna go there. It's a little bit of a well, you know, a thingy with stuff. I don't know. Right, what's causing you all that noise pollution exactly? Because I feel like you're in a residential area. Or perhaps you're not? See, that's why I think we need to have this. That's where it needs to be, apparently, because all the fire's on the beach. So there you go. I feel like this whole interchange needs to go underground if I'm going to be doing this. Okay, so. Here's what we're gonna do. Time for some construction. Because we wanted to expand the city, so here we go. I'm not even sure why I made this f that many lanes. Maybe it would look nicer if it was just the two. Those intersections feel very close together. Like that's probably going to cause problems close together. Why don't we? Oh, no, that's not what I meant to do. Make this one intersection. That way, we don't have too many intersections too close together. And then what we can do is have a little entryway. Two lanes each, so that's perfect. That's going to be four lanes. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. Oh, that's an ugly intersection. So one of the things I've been debating about is what to do for the next time that I, because I'd like to do another city for sure. This is not going to be the end of Cities Skylines. This is my favorite game by far, and I have no intention of not playing it. What I need to figure out is what exactly to do next. Because I have a couple of ideas. I definitely want to get park life. But then, do I want to do another kind of like no limit city? Because the other idea that I had was to do a was to do a stream. Which is sort of like a kind of challenge where I would. I move that over here, that's right. Go here or there. Well, that's annoying. Well, I guess the decals aren't working for whatever reason. Damn, this is what I'm running into is I need to remember to use these extra lanes because that's basically how we do turn lines in this game, which I'm really just starting to get used to. Oops. Obviously, it would be super nice if they were to have some sort of option in the next version to better have better control individually over what we're going to do here. Individual control over lanes and such. Only because this is very difficult to control. So you can go there, you can go there, and you can go there. That way no one has to stop. Maybe it is just easier. If we allow U-turns there. No, but I don't like that. Okay, why don't we do this? For right now, hello, welcome to the stream. Thank you very much for watching. I'm currently working through some issues with connecting this highway into the downtown area over here. So that's basically what I'm working on right now. I'm trying to figure out a way to maintain, to keep some sort of exit scenario where people can maybe that's what I need to do. Instead of going up to three lanes, I can go down to one lane. And then back again. I think what I'm going to do instead here is just do a straight connector. And then highways, highway ramp, national road. Why don't I have a one-lane highway? We can do an exit ramp instead, I suppose. It's not ideal, but it works. In fact, let's just upgrade that so we don't have to worry about other things. Because Because the problem is, if we go up to three lanes here, so that this remains two lanes, then this needs to be three lanes again when this comes back in, and then that needs to be six lanes. So maybe that's just what I should do. Okay, we're going back. Going back on my word again. It's the Roman show where Roman constantly changes his mind and can't stick to any one thing. Nope, wrong one. No, yes, that's correct. Three and three, then these are two and two. And then these are three. And three. And in fact, they can be three all the way down to here. That way, that one can just turn off, that one can turn on, and we don't have to worry about it. Do do. And do, and then we do. That's better, but then that looks silly. Let's see. I'm gonna do that and then that. I'm gonna do this. And I'm not really too. Concerned with how big this is. That does not look great. Well, let's keep it like that for now. It's functional. I read somewhere that apparently in engineering there's a saying where if it looks stupid, but it works, it's not stupid. So let's see if it works. And then we'll let that be the judge of how good or terrible this intersection is. Because I suspect there will be lots of people coming in this way now that we have more stuff. And you know what I'm gonna do? I know that it's pretty and everything, but I'm going to turn off dynamic weather for right now. Just because, as much as this computer can handle stuff, it can't handle having all the mods, and then also having rain, because that seems to be what happened here. Well, how important is that? It's not important at all. So we're going to go ahead and destroy both of those. Cool. Okay, so this is going to be where the magic happens. It's not nearly as much as I wanted. I mean, we're adding some intersections here, but they're not major intersections like they used to be, so I don't think it's going to be as big of a problem as it was before. Maybe this should still... Maybe it should at least go down to 4 rather than to 2. And then it goes down to 2 there. So that what we can do here is have this be right turn only. This one goes straight. This one goes straight or left. And then, yeah. That's the only one I really want to monitor. And this one can go straight. This one can go to any of these. Okay. Sorry, bus, I don't think that's where you wanted to go, but alas. Actually, I changed my mind again. I do not want left turns from this intersection. You can go straight. You can go straight. And you can go right. But no one's going to be turning left. Hopefully that doesn't cause too many problems. I think it's going to divert a lot of traffic through there, which might be a problem. So, we'll see. We'll see, we'll see, we'll see. There's a lot of demand for commercial, but not a lot of demand for residential. So, what I'm going to do is follow my plan, which is to expand the city all the way to here. So let's start off with this nice hill. How about that? Why don't we put some kind of monument or something here? Looking for something with a nice large profile but a small footprint. A small footprint. The Workers' Party Memorial. That could work. That could work very well. Okay, let's do that. Let's just do one intersection so that we don't have to. Lovely. Okay. And then we're going to go here. Now, do we want to do another leisure specialization area? Or do we want to do something else? We can do some residential through here as well. I'm actually going to downgrade these to 4 lanes. Because if this is the main traffic, okay, so what we need here is some kind of raised terrain. This is the... Oh, no! Okay, what we need here is some sort of artificial landmass prevent this kind of thing from happening. Ugh. So we created an artificial lake here, and apparently what had happened was that I was not monitoring the situation, and so this was supposed to maintain a specific level of water that did not quite work out, apparently, mostly because this area down here is lower than the level surface of the lake. So we need to monitor that, make sure that the ridge around the lake is large enough to retain that water, which I'm not sure that it is at this point. All right, how much does this pumping capacity? 120,000. Draining capacity, 24,000. 24 plus 24 is 48. 48 plus 24 is 20. 48 plus 24 is 60, 70, 72. So this should not be producing more, especially because it seems like we might have finally... No, we still have tons and tons of water. It looks like that might have leveled out finally. Come along now. And we are nearly done. There we go. Okay. All right, hopefully that stays there. Anyway, back to this. I suppose. Oh. What on earth? What happened to our water sewage? Hold on just a minute. Sewage is backing up? Not operating. Okay, why not? Not sure what that was all about, but it seems like it's been resolved. Okay. Just to be safe. I'm going to go ahead and add some more. I've never really been sure why all these buildings have to be roadside when there are no cars needed for it. You know what I mean? Oh, Lord. Okay, I hear helicopters. We should be covered over here. We should be fine. Okay. What are you doing now? All right, well, clearly move. This is clearly a terrible way to bail to art of bailed. This is clearly a terrible way to build an artificial lake. But the only way that I know functionally how to do it, so, you know. You want to be a dog? Roof, you know? Oh, Lord, please don't turn this into a river. That is really the last thing that I need. I'm starting to think that this artificial lake business was a terrible idea. Okay, back to business. To defeat the Huns. Right. These were being transformed into smaller four-lane roads. In order to... Oh, one of the other things I wanted to do... Sorry, as I was saying before about what I wanted to do next in terms of city skylines, is I thought it would be fun to do I found a couple of maps that are basically just like not outlines of the United States, but like what's it called? You know, like a not a trace, but just a, it's a map that's laid out how the United States is laid out, and I thought it might be fun to do something like that. To do that as a map and just kind of have fun with that, see what comes of it, you know? I might end up adding a highway exit over here. Because I have a sneaking suspicion that once I start building this, that this will become insanely crowded. And I kind of think that this needs to have its own exit. But then I'm also worried that... Then this intersection will get too crowded, but, you know... You take the good, you take the bad. Don't know where that's supposed to go, but it's just going to go underground. There we are. I don't know where I want to put that exit. You know, barely anyone uses this. So what if we turn that into the main highway exit? And then if people want to get off from there, this highway, then they can do that. Well, let's worry about that when we get to it. How about that? All right, so we've got some more demand, which is good. So let's start off with some. Did we say we wanted to do more residential over here? I think we did, but this seems to be filling up quite nicely. Eventually, the goal will be to sort of connect this city all the way around, but for right now, these are going to be their own separate little cities. So let's see, what do we want to do here? I don't know, this feels like it could be more of a working area if that's gonna be. All right, you know what? Fine, I'm sorry. Ugly as hell, but whatever. Okay. So I guess over here I'm gonna go for like a more old town kind of vibe. So this can be like a little downtown old town area. And just for the sake of it, I'm going to name this there's another area near where I live called the Mosaic District. Lol, ugly as hell, big mood. Well, right? Every time I look in the mirror, that's my mood. Welcome, Pella GTZ. How are you doing tonight? We're working on the Mosaic District right now, which is kind of inspired by an area near my place, near where I live, but kind of not because I've actually never been there that I know of. So we will see how it goes. We're gonna make this walkable as all get out. By having lots of pedestrian-only paths. To kind of give it that old town feeling. Actually, I'm gonna keep that zonable, but I'm doing well, thanks. I'm doing well. Just trying to keep it all together, you know? Aren't we all? So basically, I just want this to be very walkable, very modern, very hip. I'm probably gonna do the modern housing thing around here, so that we can get some fancy houses. And I'm gonna do this up here. Probably have a lot of public transportation just in this area specifically. Then we're gonna have some. That's not what I wanted. I want paths. And we're turning off snapping. Okay, there aren't supposed to be cars on any of these. So, I don't know what the hell's going on with you. You are definitely not an emergency vehicle, are you? What are you? Oh, you're a road maintenance truck. Okay, never mind. It's almost like I did it on purpose, Bella, even though I didn't. I was not on purpose, but it did kind of turn out like that, didn't it? Oy, I'm a mess. Where are those people? Hold on. Oh, I know exactly where you're going. High wealth young adult. Damn, high wealth, and you're walking all the way over here to the Workers' Party Monument, huh? Damn. Maybe they're not class traitors after all, you know? They're gonna walk all the way over there. Maybe they're down for the proletariat, you know? Oops. Okay, that's nice. Now we'll do a little bit of light commercial down this main front. Some storefronts there and here. But for most of this, I really want it to be like an old town kind of feel. I also found out this week, that's the one that I did actually do some research on separately, which was that apparently the baseline for taxes is 12%. That's the like the minimum, I should say. That's the most you can charge at like the baseline. But you can actually charge more if you are if you increase property values. So, let's see. Then I really want everything else basically to be low density. Ew, don't do that. That's the thing. I know in the real Mosaic District near my house, it's like, okay, it doesn't actually have specific mosaics in it that I know of, so it's just kind of called that for no clear reason. But like, I guess that's what they want, so it was a whole rebranding thing that they did apparently, where they, I guess, are basically gentrifying the whole area, and so they really wanted a hip new name for themselves, and so they call themselves the Mosaic District. I don't even know what I want this to be yet, but we'll see. So we'll just get rid of this actually. Because I don't want it yet, so why are we gonna do it if I don't have it yet or want it yet? Oh, that's so cute actually. Does it have anything to do with actual memories, or is it just kind of like a cute name? Because I know most places have like a main street, and it tends to actually be like a main street. Oh no. Stop that. Oh. There we go. Policies. We're going to say recycling, smoking ban. We'll always use helicopters instead of ground vehicles? No. Just a weird street name, huh? Yeah. Sometimes it just be like that, you know? Tax relief. Lowest tax rate. City planning. Small business enthusiast. High-tech housing. High-rise ban for sure. Make sure there are optional routes available because businesses in the city need to send and receive deliveries. No heavy transport vehicles allowed, does not affect highways. Encourage biking. NIMBY and Old Town. Cool. Okay. So it's a little bonkers, but let's see how that goes. There we have our first resident. And we are going to need power for you all, aren't we? Good thing I caught that just in time. Oops. Hopefully we don't have. Yes, so different roads. Sorry, to answer your question, Bella, which is, can you make biking lanes? So most of the street options within the game offer a biking lane option. So for four-lane roads, Before they remove bicycle lanes. So this is what the bicycle lanes look like. They're the green lanes there. That's what it looks like in the four-lane version. Then there's also, is this it? Decorative grass, no. And they have the six-lane road. That's still decorative grass. Where are the bike lanes? Here it is. Yeah, on the road. So these are on the road. There are also specific bicycle paths that you can do, which I'm sure you know about already, which is just that, and it's only for bicycles, I guess. But yeah, so the bicycle lanes are pretty much available for just about every road set. The smallest, I think, being two-lane with bicycle paths. And other than that, I don't think they have small roads with these. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. So I have the network extension. Network extensions mod, which gives you a couple of extra tabs with different types of roads. And one of the things it does is it has one-lane roads for cars with two lanes of bicycle traffic. And one of the nice things about City Skylines, too, is that they offer the asset editor, which allows you to create your own assets. So you can go into the asset editor within the game and basically create your own road style. So if you want these, you know, if you want to turn one of these into bike lanes, you can do that in the asset editor. And plus, you can also, if you're like me and don't really know how to use the asset editor quite yet, you can also just download stuff from the workshop, which has a lot of featured stuff. That's where I got these. That's where I got this road, which is, what is it, six lanes? Four-lane tram boulevard with bikes and trams. So you can see here it has these nice little benches, nice trees, and center tram lined tram lanes, which is shared with that, and there's parking. So, yes, to answer, that's the long-winded way of saying yes, you can definitely have roads with bike lanes in City Skylines. And then, for instance, these are only for pedestrians, and what we saw earlier were actually road maintenance vehicles, which count as emergency vehicles in this case. I hate that there are... Okay, there should not be stoplights here. Nor here. Nor here. Nor here, nor here, nor here. That's probably going to cause a lot of traffic down the road once we have more people. Although we might actually need them here because we might do extensions there, so I'm going to keep those there. Yes, I'm not sure what you're referring to specifically as convenient, but they have a lot of... It's a very detailed game. If you get into it, really, I'm not even as into it as some other people are. I've seen people with specialized mods where they can control just about everything. They can go in and like control how many workers are in each building. They can control what types of workers, so... Here you see, you know, uneducated workers, educated, well-educated, highly educated. And there are people who want so much control over this that they're like, no, we need to have this many educated, this many uneducated, whatever. And it's pretty insane. I wish you were not so tall and not covered with burgers. way. This is expanding slowly but surely. One of the other things you can do in the workshop and the asset editor is download new houses and shops and stuff. You can get new content because sometimes if you're just playing the vanilla game, which means the game with no mods and no anything extension or any kind of custom content, the buildings can get a little bit repetitive. So I've downloaded a couple. I don't think I've gotten any a lot of low density shops, especially. But I don't know. Okay, why is there death over here? We got a crematorium, so that should be able to cover everything. No more room empty. This is Buffalo Bluff, Bella. It's a little island full of rich people. How are the property values on Buffalo Bluff? Let's check that out. Land value. High. Low and high. So, low here, but pretty high there. So, tell you what I'm gonna do. Let's have a little experiment, shall we? We're gonna go into policies, taxation. And we're gonna do tax raise and tax raise. I don't think I have any offices. So we're gonna raise taxes here. I cannot imagine how much time these programmers spend on these games. I gotta say, I can I'm the kind of person who feels like a hacker, you know, I feel like a part of Anonymous when I'm using Excel. So to know how much detail goes into them, just even just the base game. Yeah, and I call it Buffalo Bluff because I don't know if there are any left, but at one point there were some wild buffalo roaming around the island. They're probably extinct at this point. I don't know if wild animals continue to spawn once an area is developed, but yes, sorry, to your other point. Absolutely. It's just incredible how much detail goes into these games, how much time and effort and everything is spent on just every single little thing. It's absolutely bonkers. Okay, why are you upset? Your land value is through the roof. You should not be upset. Okay, fine. Average land value. Whatever. Okay. Oh, you're on fire because I don't have any fire coverage here. Then we're going to put a larger one over here. Hopefully that should cover everybody. And we need a fire tower up here. Yeah, they're probably dead. You're right. I mean, Manifest Destiny and all that, right? If the buffalo wanted this land so bad, they should have, I don't know, made up taxes like we did, you know? Do you ever stop to think about that? How things like taxes and jobs and all that stuff is just invented by people? Like, we could just be chilling at home. Clothes were invented by people. All the stuff that's sort of like these little inconveniences in life. It's like, we really did that to ourselves, didn't we? Okay. You, sir, ma'am, are not an emergency vehicle. What are you doing? God damn it, Brittany. You're gonna kill some pedestrians. Well, I think the problem is at this point the land value on Buffalo Bluff does not justify a raised, which is weird because it showed that the land value is high. See, like high land value is green. This whole area is like super green. So I don't get why the people, maybe it's too close to this one in some of these areas. I really don't know how to raise this land value anymore, but just out of curiosity. Very high land values in here. Maybe this is a better place to do that. Ooh. Okay. That's nice. Very, very nice in here. Nice. Okay. Fair enough. How's traffic doing? That's bad. Maybe. Okay, is everyone going over there though? That's the real question here. Looks like half and half. And it looks like there's actually a bunch of people coming from that side. So, I think if I expand this. I'll tell you what, I'm feeling particularly lazy right now. So let's do. Circular highway exit. Half Clover Trumpet Interchange. That's huge. Highway squared exit. The beast. Let's do this one because that's going to be simple enough to attach to everything. Oh. And I'm going to just downgrade this to four lanes. And there we go. Problem solved. That should hopefully. Ooh. Ah. Turn snapping back on. Much nicer. Hopefully that will minimize the total amount of traffic that's trying to go out that way. But eventually, this intersection will need to be upgraded. And or moved. I don't know at this point. What time is it? 11:30. I should probably start thinking about coming to a good stopping point, but not quite yet. Let's see how the Mosaic District is doing. It's fine. I still need a lot of Why didn't I fix that? This is probably why. Okay. We're going to turn on Road Anarchy. And there we go. That's much better now. Like nobody's using these exits. Interesting. What about natural resources? What do we have? We have some forestry, we have some ore. And we have some farming. So what are we missing? Oil. That's what we don't seem to have any of. Tell you what, let's go ahead and paint some oil. All up in here. Nice. Because on top of that, then we can I'm just going to do some because those are prettier. Height too high. Oh, damn it. Do those things not go off the ground? They don't. Okay, never mind. And then what's nice is that this area will then be able to connect directly to the outside. Trust me, water is not going to be a problem over here with the number of times this area is flooded. Welcome, welcome. I see a new person in the stream. Welcome. We are currently building some oil fields. And we're actually going to need a name for the district. Bella, do you have any ideas for the name of this oil drilling district? These here. There we go. And where can we bring power from? We can bring it along here. That's not what it at all, actually. I was just looking at the background by mistake, rather than what I had selected. Okay, there's this, there's that, and there's there. Okay. There's oil in them thar hills. And hopefully we'll be able to process it somewhere. But that will be for another time. I actually kind of like how that looks with the old freight house. It makes it kind of look like rustic and, I don't know, just rustic, and like these oil fields have been here since the, you know, 19th century or something. How's this doing? This is another artificial lake that I created. Partly accidentally, because I had built this dam Hounds Lake. No, actually, that sounds like a fabulous name. You know why? Because there is a lake. It's not a lake, but there, but there's the lake right next door. I love that. Hold on. Hounds Lake. That's perfect. Because we can have, like, a lore behind it. Where, like, you know, Obadiah Hounds was the first to discover oil here. In the, you know, whenever. And, so the area is all named after him, and, like, he actually haunts the area because he was murdered for his money or something, you know? Awesome. I love it. Great suggestion, Bella. Because then he can be the one who was like, no, I'm going to create an artificial lake here because, oh, that's awesome. Then we can have, like, because I had been meaning to build some residential areas up here, and that can be our sort of backstory, is that they found oil here. So I'm actually going to call this Hounds Lake Industrial Park or Hounds Lake Fields. That way we can have this area also be called Hounds Lake. And then this is actually the Hounds Lake because this guy was like, you know what? I want to bring a lake. I want my house next to a lake, but I want it next to my oil field. And they're like, but Mr. Hounds, you can't do that. There's no. Oh. Well, you know, it works. If it works, it works. And then he was like, well, you know what? Then I'm gonna go ahead and make a lake. And they're gonna be like, no, but Mr. Hounds, it's gonna be so expensive. And he's like, do you see all my oil fields? Do you see them? And then he'll say something like from that movie with what's his face? He's like, I drink your milkshake. I drink your milkshake. So, anyway, great suggestion is what I was trying to say before I got completely distracted by my own bonkers backstory. But Mr. Hounds, no, we can't do that. You'll do it and you'll like it. I'm gonna put the lake right on your house. And he did. He did because he had all the money, he had all the resources. And he was like, I'm flooding this whole valley. Y'all better not be thinking about any kind of not listening to me. And I don't know, I had this one too, so maybe like his rival, Mr. Katz, was over here. He was like, I want to do that too, but I don't have nearly as much money, and I don't have the right land for that, so. That'll be Cat's Lake. How about that? Are we okay? We should have some more forestry stuff around here just in case as we start building. Because as we start expanding over here, we definitely want to keep things safe. Seat belts, so we can be safe. And then we need an actual fire station here. Then how about police station as well. And then we can also do that there and see. Hopefully, that doesn't cause too much traffic. The freight stations do have a tendency to cause giant backups, which is not what I am about. But we shall see. Oh Lord, here we go again. This is pretty much the problem that has hounded me. I actually didn't mean to do that. I'm sorry. Well, you know what? Maybe Mr. Hound's likes living on the edge, Bella. Okay, yeah, I know that they're living on top of fuel, but maybe Mr. Hound's was like, fire station? We don't need no fire station. You need to put it out by yourselves. That's the American way. You have to do everything by yourself. You never ask for help, not even from the police. I don't know. He's slowly changing regions every time we give him a new voice. but okay. This is the problem that has hounded me throughout the whole playthrough, and honestly throughout all of my experiences in City Skylines, which is that my industrial areas never seem to have enough workers to the point where there's just widespread abandonment. It's actually not as bad right now as it used to be, but generally speaking, there's like just constantly all of these areas are just full of... I'm actually quite surprised. I think it's just because I stopped building it for a very long time. And I've continued to build more and more residential. Because for a lot of... Why are you sick? Oh, okay, you're not sick anymore. Exactly! So that's... Yes, you're right. That's what the lake is for. That's exactly it. So he's like, if there's ever a fire, we just demolish part of the wall, the flood wall. The flood wall that is the only thing coming between us and imminent doom. You know? Ooh, actually, I have an even better idea for a backstory. What if this isn't an artificial lake? What if it used to run from the river and actually... all of this used to be the lake, and then he somehow found oil at the bottom of the lake, or heard that there was oil at the bottom of the lake, and so he was like, oil at the bottom of the lake? Yes, please. And so he went through and he dug and he found it, and then he made so much money off of that oil that he actually dug a huge wall and blocked off half the lake, and was able to basically drain half the lake. And so this is actually the old dry lake bed. That seems like the Mr. Hounds that we know and love. He seems like just the kind of person who... And actually, that there we go. And then we can just change this back to Hounds Lake, because that's sort of like the irony of it. So even after he died a long time... Yeah, exactly, drain that shit. And even though he died a long time ago, they still call it that as like this irony, to be like, oh yeah, Hounds, I'm going to go swimming in Hounds Lake. It's like, really? Are you? Because there's no water there. It's like, exactly. That's the joke, girl. I like that. See, Bella? We're a good team, you and I. We're a good team. What's abandoned over here? And actually, even this area is filled in nicely, because before, like I said, all of my industrial areas were just an ocean, an absolute ocean of... Just not enough workers, not enough workers, not enough workers. Are you done emptying? So let's not be emptying anymore. There is a mod that automatically starts to empty cemeteries, but teamwork does make the dream work. But, I don't know. I feel like I already have so many mods, and I'm just so nervous about having too many that I really don't want to risk it. Why do you still have dead people problems? Because that should have been resolved. Okay, maybe it was resolved. Wait, nope, I see you. I see you trying to hide from me. There it goes. Oh, they have a little coffin? Oh my God! So, Bella, one of the things that I guess keep having to tell, not having to tell people, but keep reminding people is that part of the reason that this is so exciting for me is because the little coffin, oh my God. My old computer was a is it's actually what I'm using to read the chat on the stream channel. What it is a Sony Vaio from 2011. And it's garbage. In fact, this is what it sounds like. If you're wondering what that weird whirring, whooshing sound in the background is, because I can't hear it too much because of my headphones, but I know the mic probably picks it up. That's what my Sony Vaio sounds like. It overheats like nobody's business. Oh! Fell to the boardwalk. It was so bad that I had to turn down all the graphics to like the minimum. I had to, and then I also had to turn off weather, turn off night, day and night cycle. All that made it a little run okay, but I couldn't do subways without having the entire game crash. So, needless to say, it was not an ideal situation. I couldn't look at the game really nicely. The animations didn't run smoothly. I was barely playing the game, and it was all on vanilla because I couldn't put mods. I had a couple of custom assets because I could work with those, but other than that, I didn't have anything, and it wasn't even awful. I still loved playing the game, but I got a new computer. Yeah, sorry about that, Bella. Unfortunately, I had enough money for a new computer, but not enough for a new computer and a new laptop. I'm actually still paying off this computer, so the fact that I have quote unquote money for this lap for this computer has yet to be seen. But basically, so whenever you see me get excited about those little tiny things like little animations and things like that, that's why, because my old computer was crap and I couldn't see anything, I couldn't zoom in, I couldn't watch the animations, I couldn't enjoy a good like 60% of the game because my computer was so bad. We need some parks up in here, don't we? I mean, you say you're okay, and that's probably because I have all these golf courses, but let's do some nice parks here on the outskirts. I don't know why the dog park is one of my favorite parks in this game, but it just is. I'm glad it's faint because I've been worried about that. Because whenever I take off my headphones, it's like actually very loud to me. So I'm glad that it's fainter to you. I also worry a bit about my breathing. I don't know if I'm like breathing in your ear. I keep trying to move the microphone to a good distance, so I hope I'm not like heavy breathing creepily into your ears. One of the nice things about playing with no money, or I should say playing with infinite money, is what you're hearing right now, which is you can basically just place a couple of, because you don't have to worry about money, you can place a bunch of stuff into one neighborhood all at once, and it causes all the buildings to upgrade. Okay, perfect. Thank you, Bella. You made me feel a lot better. Is that so the buildings all upgrade basically all at the same time. So a lot of times you'll hear these little bursts of the dun 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 dun, that one, and the little arrows, which is the buildings being upgraded, which means I think for residential means they can hold more people. I guess for, oh, that's an arrow. Oh. So I had seen that, because I was on the old one too. I guess I'd only ever really kind of looked at it in the residential things, so I thought it was a little house. Because it looks like a little house. But I just now, for the first time, playing this game in the last like 3 or 4 years, realized that that's actually an arrow, because it's on the non-house properties as well. So there you go. I think you also need more services. So let's do a bus. Oh, wait. Do we have a tram line coming out here somewhere? Not yet. Tell you where a tram line would be nice, though. So kind of like in San Francisco, we're gonna have a tram line going all along this mountain ridge. One of the other things that I really want to get at some point soon, which is why I'm thinking I might not even want to do anything crazy and just do another city at some point, soon, is to basically do another, what am I saying? Mass transit is one of the other. Mass Transit is one of the other download, or I should say DLC packs that they have, which I've been wanting to do for. No, I don't want the two-lane ride. I want just the tram track. There we go. Actually, I think I can just do this. I don't need all of that business. Maybe we can make this a larger nature preserve. But anyway, Mass Transit is one of the other DLC packs that I really want to get, because it has more public transportation options, including cable cars and monorail and ferries. And that is definitely something that I want to explore. That wasn't what I wanted. So that's why I'm thinking that maybe rather than trying to do something fancy or crazy, I can basically just focus on getting that DLC and just starting a new city and playing around with that. But we'll see how it goes. I haven't quite given up on this city yet. I watch a lot of Flabaliki though, and he always says, and I think rightly so, that once you start having to like force yourself to do stuff in a city, excuse me, then that's when you start to run into problems, and that's when you're going to start to. Kind of just not want to do it anymore. So for now, we're going to keep plugging away. That's very noisy. Let me put that right here. And then, well, you know what? That's too far over here. Okay, so that should be that. Then this is going to go back to. This city, Bella, I've been working on for. I guess the last couple of weeks, maybe 2 months now, 1 month, 2 months, something like that. Let me double check. How about that? That way I can give you a definite date. Channel. I'm checking on YouTube to see. When my first upload was for City Skylines. Okay, so part one was posted about a month ago. So maybe 4 or 5 weeks I've been working on this city. And that's with like about how many episodes now? Last episode was 18. So almost 20 episodes. So about 20 sessions, 2 hours each. So about 40 hours I've put into this city. And I don't know, I think I like it so far for the 40 hours that I've put into it. I remember now why I didn't like this road, because it takes the trees away when you put it in a new stop. But alas, it's better than nothing. Oh, for heaven's sakes. Okay. I need to remember to do this every time. Select types. We don't need that many people. What's your capacity? 120. Regular tram capacity is 90. Okay, KM plus KP plus KP tram. 140. Let's just do 3, 4 of these. 5, 6. Oh, that's ugly. That's not what I wanted at all. Oh well. It works just fine. Let's just follow. Ooh. We can follow this tram for a little bit, unbunching in progress. My stream just, not the stream itself, but what I was watching just now crashed, so I just had to restart it. So hopefully didn't miss something that you said in chat, but if I did, I apologize. Tell you what, let's go just all the way up to It's interesting to me that so far everyone who is getting on the tram is going back this way for some reason. Because just now, I guess maybe the other trams, excuse my yawn, had been picking up other people. Kind of a loop. Why can you not turn left? Yeah, I guess I can just do something going up to there and then back around. That's fine. And because I have it paused, which is my one piece of advice to you if you use... Oh, I'm sorry about that. Hope it's working okay now. One, two, three, four, five. Where are you going first? I really don't see why it would take this route. The driving AI in this game. Oh, if it's that's the first stop, then okay, I see that. I don't know why that's the first stop, though. Yeah, it's my favorite. It's my all-time favorite movie, Bella. Singing in the Rain is hands down my all-time favorite movie, and I cannot tell you how many times I have watched that film. I had the old VHS version growing up. I'm sure that tape is so worn down at this point. I remember by the end of the time that I had a VHS player, I watched it so many times that it was damaged, visibly damaged. Like I said, I cannot tell you how much I quote that movie on a regular basis, and everyone looks at me like I'm insane, because no one has seen that movie, and or even if they've seen it, they can't like recite it word for word like I can, which, granted, is not necessarily the thing. But like, earlier today, in fact, I was watching a friend's stream. I had it on in the background at work. And he said something, like some sort of innuendo, and all I could think of was, it's vulgar, from that scene where they do the test of the sound. And I can't tell you how many times someone says to me something with the word people in it. And even if it's completely unrelated to what Lena Lamott was saying in her thing, I always, always, always am like, people? I ain't people. I'm a glowing, shimmering star in the cinema firmament. And I can't stand them. Fun fact about that movie, actually. If you're as big a fan of the movie as I am, then you definitely know this already. But if not, in the film itself, when they show Debbie Reynolds' character, I can't remember the name of the character? That's bad. Don Lockwood and Lena Lamott. Kathy is her name. When they show Kathy dubbing over Lena's parts in the film, and you hear her, "Nothing can keep us apart. Our love will last till the stars turn cold." That's actually Jean Hagen, who plays Lena Lamott. That's her real voice. So normally she's like, well, you know, she puts on that Lena voice. But then in the scenes where she's being dubbed over by quote-unquote Kathy, that's not even Debbie Reynolds' voice. That is Jean Hagen doing her own bits. So it was this, like, really cool, layered thing that they did. And just one of the many, many reasons why I love that movie so much. Alrighty, well, it is past midnight on my end, so unfortunately I'm going to have to bring this to a close. But thank you so much, Bella, and everyone else who watched. I really do appreciate the views, and I appreciate having someone to chat with. I appreciate finding another Singing in the Fan Rain. Another fan of Singing in the Rain. I would love it if you would follow for more stuff. We can come back and chat more. I will talk about Singing in the Rain till the cows come home. I promise you. And if not, that's fine too. If you're watching this on YouTube after the fact, you can find me on Twitch at Voidco Studios. But please do like and subscribe. And tell me about what you think of my city in the comments below. If you have any suggestions, criticisms, critiques, ideas, whatever. I'm looking forward to hearing from you. Alrighty. Have a great night. Bye.